Om Shri Sai Ram. Last class we have studied about equations of motions. Some of the equations are v equal to u plus at, then s equal to ut plus half at square, v squared minus u squared equal to 2s. These are the different equations of motion, and we have solved many problems according to these equations. The last topic of this chapter is uniform circular motion. What do you mean by motion? When we say the object is moving, if the position of the object changes with respect to time, then we say that object is moving, it is in motion. So, uniform circular motion. What do you mean by uniform circular motion? Some of the objects move along a straight line, then some of them are move along a circular path. Yes, circular path means it is circular motion. Now tell me, what do you mean by circular motion? There is any difference between straight motion and circular motion? Yes, there is some difference. For example, this is a ball. If I hold the ball and if move along a circular path, and it is example for circular motion. Why it is circular motion? Because this object means the ball which moves along a circular path, therefore it is called circular motion. What is a circular motion? A body or a object which moves along a circular path. If it is a center, then the object or any body which moves along a circular path, then we say it is a circular motion, but it's not uniform circular motion. When we say it is a uniform circular motion, uniform means the object move along a circular path with constant speed, then it is called uniform circular motion. Very simple. What is uniform circular motion? The object or any body which moves along a circular path with constant speed. The speed is same. It means the speed is same means if it covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. For example, this point is A to B is 1 meter. For example, it is 1 meter. Then B to C, it is once again 1 meter. C to D, it is once again 1 meter. Now equal distance, it requires equal intervals of time to cover equal distances. It means A to B 1 meter, B to C 1 meter, C to D 1 meter, it takes 1 second to reach this 1 meter. It takes 1 second to reach B to C 1 meter, then it takes 1 second to reach C to D 1 meter. So it covers equal distances in equal intervals of time. Why speed? What do you mean by speed? Speed means the distance traveled by time. The rate of distance traveled is called speed. Therefore, it covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. Then this circular motion is called uniform circular motion. Why? Because the speed is constant. Very simple. So what is circular motion? Circular motion means the object which moves along a circular path, then it is called circular motion. This is example for circular motion. Now this is example for circular motion. Because the ball moves along a circular path, therefore it is circular motion. Now tell me, is it circular motion? No, it is not circular motion. It is oscillation. This is called oscillation. Now what do you mean by uniform circular motion? The object which moves along a circular path with constant speed means uniform circular motion. Another example, you must have enjoyed the ride in a giant wheel. It is also example for giant wheel. It is also example for circular motion. Now tell me, speed is uniform. What about velocity? What do you mean by velocity? Velocity means the displacement, the rate of displacement. It means velocity equal to displacement by time. Displacement by time. What about velocity? Is it uniform or it's changing? It is changing. Why? Because if we hold the ball, this is a ball, for example, now it rotates in a circular path. Why it rotates in a circular path? Because we holding the ball. If we release the ball at this point, ball moves in this direction. But this force which holds the ball to reach here, because of the force. If we release the ball here, it moves in the in a straight line. Therefore, every time the direction of the ball changes, so velocity is changing. The velocity is changing means there is a acceleration. Okay. Now tell me, what is displacement in this? This is a circumference. So circumference of this circle of radius r is 2 pi r. It is 2 pi r. What is 2 pi r? 2 pi r is a circumference of a circle of radius r is 2 pi r. Time is t. Therefore, v equal to 2 pi r by t. This is a very important formula. What is v? Velocity equal to 2 pi r by t. This is the important formula. Yes. Now go through the textbook, page number 112. There are given many problems in exercise 1 to 10 problems. In that fourth problem, look at the fourth problem exercise, page number 112. A motor boat starting from rest on a lake accelerates in a straight line at a constant rate of 3.0 or 3 meter per second square for 8 seconds. How far does the boat travel during this time? Just understand what is given in the problem. A motor boat starting from rest. So what is the initial velocity? Starting from rest means initial velocity is denoted by the letter u. What is the starting from rest means? What is the initial velocity? Initial velocity is 0 or 0 meter per second, or we can write 0 as it. Okay, 0. On a lake accelerates. The velocity changes with respect to time. Accelerates in a straight line at a constant rate of 3.0 or 3 meter per second square or 3 meter second to the power minus 2. So what is acceleration? It is denoted by the letter A. So 3 meter per second square. We can write meter per second square. Straight line at a constant rate of 3 meter per second square for 8 seconds. 8 seconds means time. It is denoted by the letter T. So 8 seconds. How far does the boat travel during this time? So what you have to calculate? How far you have to write the, find the distance traveled by that boat or motor boat. That is S, small s. It is S. Find the distance, S. Now, which formula we can use? S equal to ut plus half at squared? Or v squared minus u squared equal to 2as, v equal to u plus at, which one is suitable for this? That is s equal to ut plus half at squared, because u is given, t is given, a is given. Therefore, we can use the formula s equal to ut plus half at squared. Now, substitute the values. S equal to, right, as it is, u, what is the value of u? U is 0, so 0. U into t, that is 0 into t. What is t? T is 8. Plus, then plus half into a. What is the value of a? A equal to 3. Into t square. T square means t into t. What is the value of t? It is 8. So, can I write 8 into a? 8 squared or 8 into 8. Now substitute. 2 1s are 2, 4s are. So, S equal to 0 into 8. If any number which multiplies 0, the product is always 0. So, 0. Now, 3 into 4, we get 12 into 8. Now, 8 2s are 16. One is left. 8 1s are 8, 1 9. So, 96 meter, kilometer or centimeter or millimeter. Which SI unit you have to write? It is given in meter per second squared, so 96 meter. Now we get the answer. How far does the boat travel during this time? How far? the boat travels 96 meter in 8 seconds. In 8 seconds. This is the answer for this question. In the same exercise, look at the 7th problem. A ball is gently dropped from a height of 20 meter. A ball is dropped from a height of 20 meter. If its velocity increases uniformly, at the rate of 10 meter per second square, with what velocity will it strike the ground? After what time will it strike the ground? Now write the datas. A ball is gently dropped from a height. Now ball is at the height 20 meter. Now it is at 20 meter means it dropped from the height 20 meter means it covers the distance 20 meter. What is the distance between the top to ground? That is 20 meter. It means the ball which travels 20 meters. So S equal to, be careful, S equal to 20 meter. Why S equal to 20 meter? It is at the height 20 meter. Then after that, it dropped from a height of 20 meter. It means it travels from 20 meter to reach the ground. So what is the distance traveled by that ball? It is 20 meter. Now, another thing, a ball is gently dropped from a height. At first, it is at rest. So what is u? What is the initial velocity? In that time, initial velocity u equal to 0. Why u equal to 0? A ball is gently dropped from a height. When it is in height, it is at rest. So what is the initial velocity? U equal to 0 meter per second, or we can write 0 because 0 it is. Then if its velocity increases uniformly at the rate of 10 meter per second squared, be careful, 10 meter per second squared, meter per second square is the SI unit of acceleration, because it accelerates. So from 0 meter per second to 10 meter per second square. Now it accelerates means acceleration, that is A. Acceleration is 10 meter per second square. It is not V. A is given. If its velocity increases uniformly at the rate of 10 meter per second square, with what velocity will it strike? What velocity means? What is final velocity? What is V? Strike the ground. After what time will it strike the ground? What time means? Find what is T. What is T? Now, S is given, U is given, A is given. Find V. What is the formula? The formula, V squared minus U squared equal to 2as. The formula is V squared minus U squared equal to 2s. Use this formula. Now, you have to find the velocity, final velocity. So, write this equation as V squared equal to. First, write 2as. Now, transpose this minus U squared to right hand side, and it becomes minus becomes plus 2as plus U squared. Now, substitute the values. V squared equal to 2 into, what is A? A equal to 10 into, what is S? S equal to 20 plus, what is U? U equal to 0 squared. Now substitute, 2 into 10, 20 into 20 plus 0 squared means 0 into 0 is always 0. So 20 into 20. 0, 0, 2, 0, 2 into 2 is 4. So, V squared equal to 400. What is V? V equal to root 400 or 20. 20 is a velocity, so meter per second, because it is in meter per second squared. So, V equal to, what is the value? What is the final velocity? What is the velocity will it strike the ground? The final velocity is 20 meter per second. Now, velocity. Then find time. Which formula is suitable to find the time? V equal to U plus AT. Use this formula. V equal to, or we required time. So AT equal to V minus U, correct? V minus U. Then T equal to V minus U. After transposing A to right hand side, now it is multiplication, it becomes division. So V minus U by A. Substitute the value. V, it is 20 meter per second, so 20 minus U means 0. The initial velocity is 0. What is acceleration? Acceleration is 10. Now 20 minus 0 means 20 by 10. 0, 0, 1, 2, 0. So 2 time, that is second. So 2 seconds. Now the answer is, what velocity will it strike the ground? What velocity? 20 meter per second. The final velocity 20 meter per second. After what time will it strike the ground? It takes 2 seconds to strike the ground from the distance 20 meter. This is the answer for this question. Now some of the problems are given in the textbook exercise, same page, page number 112. I already proved some problems 4 and 7. Now 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. These are homework. Use the same formulas. The formula is same. Equations of motion. V squared minus U squared equal to S. V equal to U plus AT. Then S equal to UT plus half AT. Use that formula to find solution for these problems. Sairam.